So, let us discuss another point in the ray optics, that is refraction through a curved surface. If refraction occurs along a curved surface, and how it will happen? Till now, this refraction we discuss on plane surface only, Nana. Real depth, apparent depth, parallel shift, lateral shift, these all things, critical angle, total internal reflection, these all things we have discussed for plane surface. Just for plane surface we have discussed. Okay? And formula you should remember, important. Now we are going to discuss about refraction phenomena for a curved surface. Okay? Again, like the mirror, concave mirror, convex mirror, here surfaces also, two types of surfaces will be there. Okay? These are two surfaces I am taking. This one surface, this another surface. Can we take like this? You can imagine that it is like a beaker, test tube in a chemistry lab like that. Here it is having a curved surface. Okay, Nana? Here, from this side ray comes, this surface is convex surface, and from this side ray comes, this surface is concave surface, and these two surfaces are curved. So we will discuss what will happen to the refraction in this case also. Okay, na? And as similar to your mirrors, they also will have focal length, radius of curvature, object distance, image distances. You know already, object distance, image distance should be measured from the pole. Clear? Yeah. Now let us imagine this is the principal axis. This is the principal axis. If your object is there, if ray comes here, this is the object distance. Somewhere let us imagine image forms. This is the image distance. Okay, na? Clear? And this surface, if we extend, it will appear to be like a one spherical surface. So it will have centered somewhere else. So that distance we call it as radius of curvature, and half of the distance we call it as focal length. Same, similar to your mirrors only. Everything will be there. Okay? Now let us discuss where image will form. When object is at some distance for this surface, where image will form, get a picture. Okay, na?
Yes.
Now, let us imagine there is one curved surface like this. Let us imagine it is a test tube like this. A glass surface it is. This is a glass surface. Okay? And let us imagine this medium is different medium, and this medium is different medium. This is different medium, this is different medium, let us imagine. Okay? Media on both sides of this curved surface is different. This is what it means. This may be total glass or total water like that. Okay, na? Clear? Are you understanding what I am saying? Okay, now let us take the object somewhere here. Here I am taking the object. Okay, na? Here?
Okay.
Now, what will happen? Ray will incident on this surface like this. This is incident ray. Clear? This is what will happen? Incident ray. Okay, then what will happen? When it will enter into the different medium, what will happen? It is not moving in the same path. It will bend towards the normal or away from the normal. Okay, sir. What is the normal here, sir? Okay. Now, for that, I am taking this one center of curvature for this spherical bowl like this. Let us imagine this is like a sphere. Let us imagine this is like a this surface. Okay, na? So it will have a center here. Getting no point, sir? Can you see this dotted line here? Can you see this dotted line here? Okay. So for this spherical surface, this is the center of curvature. Then this will be the normal. Yes or no? Yes. How to draw a normal for a curved surface? So where you want the normal, from that point, draw a line to its center. So it will become a normal. Yes, this is a normal now. Okay, this dotted line is a normal now. Now, let us imagine that ray is moving from rarer medium to denser medium. Let us imagine this is denser medium. Means N2 is greater than N1. Compared to N2 refractive index, N1 refractive index is more. Compared to N1 refractive index, N2 refractive index is more, let us imagine. That means this surface will become, this medium will become denser medium. So when ray enters into denser medium, what will happen to its path? It will deviate and it will bend towards the normal. Yes or no? When ray enters into denser medium, it will bend towards the normal. Right? Yes. So instead of going like this, it will bend towards the normal. And let us imagine somewhere else it has an scale. And one more ray which is passing through this line like this. Because it is passing through the normal. This is the normal only. Here, because this line is passing through the center. So it will pass undeviated. So these two rays entered here, your image will form here. You'll get the image here. Clear ray diagram, understood? No. This is the object and this is the image you got here. Here, this is the normal. Are you understanding what I am telling? Clear, man? Okay. Now, let us draw the angles for these all. Okay? Now, let us say the angle between these two. This is the principal axis, na? This is what, na? Principal axis. Principal axis and this is the incident ray. This let us take alpha. The angle between principal axis and incident ray is alpha, let us take. Okay? Yes. Next, the angle between, this is a refracted ray and principal axis. There it has formed. That let us imagine beta. The angle between principal axis and refracted ray, final refracted ray is beta, let us take. And one more here. Normal is intersecting the principal axis, yes or no? And let us take this angle as gamma. Let us take this angle as gamma. Clear? And two more angles you know already. The angle of incidence and angle of refraction. So, ray is going like this with the normal, how much angle it will make? That is called as angle of incidence. This is angle of incidence. Clear? Okay. Now, instead of going like this, ray is bending towards the normal. And angle between normal and refracted ray is called as angle of refraction. Angle of refraction. Now this total angle, I'll redraw one more time so that you will see clearly. Okay? This diagram only I am drawing. Only this diagram. This is a curved surface. Let us imagine this is the center. Then this will be the normal. Okay? Now let us imagine ray is incident here. Like this. This is the object. Okay? This will be the angle of incidence. Can you see this clearly now? Okay? Yes. And this will be the alpha angle, let us take. Okay? Now, because this is the denser medium, instead of going in straight path like this, instead of going like this straight, it will bend towards the normal. It will bend towards the normal. This is refracted ray. So, your image will form here. Okay? This angle takes beta. This angle take gamma. This is the angle of refraction. Angle between normal and incident ray, angle of incident. Angle between normal and refracted ray is angle of refraction. This is the gamma, nana. Gamma I am writing differently. This is R, angle of refraction. Clear? Okay? Now, from this point, I am trying to draw one perpendicular. Let us call this as, this is N and this will be N dash. This is normal and this is N dash, let us call. Okay, now? Clear? Now, you take these all angles. Actually, diagram should be this one. Because it is not visible, it may be not visible to you, that's why I have redrawn this diagram. Okay? Now, see a triangle. Which triangle, sir? See this triangle. ONC triangle. ONC triangle. Okay? O N C, this triangle you see. Okay, this is the external angle for this triangle, and these two are internal angles. Yes or no? Internal opposite angles, these two. Okay, this is the triangle what I am saying. O N C. Okay, these are two opposite angles, and this is the external angle for that. Okay, so from a triangle O N C, what we can write then? This external angle I can be written as sum of the two opposite internal angles, that is alpha plus gamma, we can write. Okay, let us take this is an equation number one. Okay, Nana? Now one more triangle you take. This triangle take C N I, this triangle C N I, this triangle. Okay, so in triangle C N I, in this triangle, this gamma angle is external angle, and R and beta are opposite internal angle for this triangle C N I. For this triangle, this is the external angle, and these two are two opposite internal angles. So we can write gamma is equal to R plus beta. R plus beta. Now take R from this. We can write gamma minus beta. This is equation number two. Clear? Okay. Got it, Nana? These equations. These two equations understood, all of you? Clear? Okay. Now what to do? Because here at this curved surface, what is happening? Which phenomenon is happening here? Refraction. Now during refraction, there are two laws should obey. What are that? First law of refraction is incident ray, refracted ray, normal should lie in a same plane. Yes, they are on board only. Yes, they are lying in same plane. What is second law? Second law is that Snell's law. What is Snell's law? Snell's law defined as N1 sin I is equal to N2 sin R. Correct? Yes or no? This is Snell's law. This should obey. Then only this refraction will occur. Okay? According to Snell's law, ratio between refractive index N2 by N1 should be equal to sin I by sin R should be equal to constant sin I upon sin R should be equal to constant. That constant is called as refractive index. And from that, if you expand, you will get this equation. N1 sin I is equal to N2 sin R. Okay? Now, let us assume one point that all these rays, this incident ray, refracted ray, normal, all these are paraaxial rays, let us imagine. Okay? If the rays are paraaxial, means these rays are very near to the principal axis. These rays are very near to the principal axis. See, if this ray is near to the principal axis, what happened to this angle? Initially this much angle. Now, angle has decreased. Means, for paraaxial rays, angle will become less small. Alpha, beta, gamma, I, R, all will become small. Clear? And for small angle, sin I can be written as tan I, sin R can be written as tan R. Yes or no? Yes. So, for paraaxial rays, we can write this equation as N1, tan I is equal to N2 tan R. Here, okay, na? Clear? Yes. Otherwise, before using this equation for paraaxial rays, N1 into sin I will become I, and N2 into sin R will become R. Okay, that means N1 into what is I from equation 1? Alpha plus gamma is equal to N2 into what is R from equation number 2? Gamma minus beta. Okay. Now, expand them. You can write N1 alpha plus N1 gamma should be equal to n2 gamma minus n2 beta. Correct? Yes. Okay, na? Yeah. See, this, I'll rearrange this. N1 alpha says n2 beta is equal to n2 gamma minus n1 gamma. Can you get this? Yes. So, what I have done here? See there, na? This. So, n1 is equal to n2 sin r. For paraxial rays, angles are very small, I and r are small. So, sin I can be written as I. Sin r can be written as r. In the place of I, I have substituted that value. In the place of r, I have substituted this value. Now expand them. Okay, n1 into alpha plus n2 in, n1 into gamma plus is equal to n2 gamma minus n2 beta. Now this n2 beta can this side. N1 gamma can that side because I take gamma common. Clear? Okay, na? Yes. Now again these angles can be written as n1 tan alpha. Can we write? Yes, we can write. Why not? Because they are small angles. Because for paraxial rays, angles will be small. Okay? For small angles, sin I will be I and tan I also I only. So, alpha will become tan alpha plus n2 into tan beta is equal to n2 minus n1 into tan gamma. I'll write. Take gamma common, you get n2 minus n1 into tan gamma. Is it visible to you clearly? Okay, no? I think board is clear, no? Okay, now see this right angle triangle, see this right angle triangle, n dash, n dash are here also. This is a right angle triangle, this is 90 degrees, this is 90 degrees. Okay, now I want tan alpha. Okay, n1 into what is tan alpha, sir? So from this triangle O N N dash, from triangle O N N dash, O N N dash, from this triangle tan alpha is opposite side by adjacent side. What is opposite side? N N dash. So N N dash upon adjacent side is O N dash. Clear? Okay, na? N plus n2 into tan beta, again triangle n n n dash I. See, this is again right angle triangle n n dash I. This is a right angle triangle. Tan beta is equal to opposite side by adjacent side. Opposite side is n n dash. So I'll write n n dash upon adjacent side is n dash I. From here to here, adjacent side n dash I, n dash I is equal to n2 minus n1 times of tan gamma. See this triangle n n dash C, this triangle n n dash C, this is a right angle triangle again. For this gamma, this is opposite side, this is adjacent side. So opposite side is again n n dash. So n n dash upon as c. Clear? Now if we see clearly, n n dash, n n dash, n n dash, they'll get cancelled. No? Take n n dash common. This and this will get cancelled. So I'm cancelling them. We'll get n1 by O n dash plus n2 by n dash I is equal to n2 minus n1 by n dash C. Now, what I have taken here assumption that paraxial ray. See, now when ray is here, if you draw a perpendicular, n dash is here. If your ray is very close, let us imagine ray is here. Now, if you draw a perpendicular, it will come very close to, means exactly to the pole. Yes or no? Clear? Means for a paraxial rays, n dash approaches, n dash will move this side to pole. Means wherever n dash is there, we can keep P simply. Okay? So we can write n1 by PO is that n2 by PI can be written as n2 minus n1 by pc. Wherever n is there, there you write p. Because assumption we have taken as per paraxial wave. Now, what is po? Distance from object to pole. What is pi? Distance from pole to image. What is pc? Pole to center of curvature. Okay? Yes. Now, let us keep the values. N1 by PO. What is PO? Object to pole distance. Let us imagine this is u distance you take. Now, whether you take positive or negative, what to take, sir? See, incident ray is moving this side. And we know that this distance always we should measure from pole. Yeah. Means we should measure. If you have a scale, we should keep the scale like this. Means we should measure in this direction. Opposite to incident ray. Means negative we should take. So, minus u. Here, plus n2 by pi. P2i. Let us imagine this is the image distance. V. Got it? Okay, now incident ray is moving like this and you are measuring distance also same direction. So we should take it as positive. So positive only here. Where is equal to n2 minus n1 by pc. P2c, pole to center of curvature, this distance what we call? We call this distance as radius of curvature of this curved surface. Now, whether to take positive or negative, because incident ray is this side and your radius also this side. So, we have to take it as positive. So, plus R. Yes, this is the formula we should take to find image distance, V, if you want. If U and R are given. N1 into U, R are given, we can find V. N1 into V, R are given, we can find U. N1 into UV given, we can find R also. Clear? What is enough? So, this derivation, if you remember, it will be very useful for us. And then, after this, we are having a length maker formula, and that we can find only by using this formula. Length maker formula. 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to N2 minus N1 by R. That is there, no? N minus 1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. That formula we will get from this only. Image formula from a curved surface. And this equation will be valid for all the types of curved surfaces. For all the types of curved surfaces. Only the thing is, here N1 into what to take. N1 is the refractive index of medium from which ray is going. Means in which medium object is there. That medium is N1. N2 is the refractive index of the medium into which ray is going. Here, what is N1 is what? N2 is what? I hope you are understanding. N1 means object you take from that object to the curved surface, draw one line. Okay. So that drawing line, way which medium is there? That medium is what? N1 medium. Now, after refraction, after passing that boundary, how ray is going, into which ray is going, that medium we have to take it as what? Second medium, N2 medium. Here, like this, we have to decide N1 and N2. So, according to the sign, according to, again, these all U, V and R, we should use sign conventions. So, what are the sign conventions again? All the distances should be measured from the pole. Distances measured in the direction of incident ray are taken as positive. The distances measured in opposite direction to incident ray are taken as negative. These are enough for us to calculate any type of problem. I hope you understand this one. Here, this derivation understood, no? Any doubt in this derivation? Any doubt, ma'am? 21 students are there. Any doubt in this equation? No doubt, sir. Okay. Now, I'll give you one question. Let us see how many of you will solve that question. See, let us imagine, yeah, this same as is only I give. There is a beaker like this. Your object is there. object distance you take 10 centimeter, this is having radius 5 centimeter radius, you take this curved surface is having 5 centimeter radius. Okay, let us imagine that this is a air, this is one vertex, I don't tell that it is n1, and this is having refractive index n is equal to, let us imagine it is a glass, means 1.5, refractive index is 1.5. Now I have given u, r, n1, n2. I want where image is formed due to this object. So where image will be formed due to this object. Okay, let us see. Formula, what is formula? Is n2 by v minus n1 by u is equal to n2 minus n1 by r. So this I am writing first because it is first two term. N2 by v minus n1 by u is equal to n2 minus n1 by r. Okay, this is the formula. Now what is n2, sir? N2 means how to decide. This is incident ray. Ray should go to this medium. Okay, so n2 is this, means 1.5 upon v. V we don't know, so we should keep v only. And which quantity you don't know, don't take sign for that quantity. All known quantities only with the sign you take. Okay, yeah. Minus n1. N1 is this medium. How much? 1. Refractive index 1 upon u value 10 centimeter. Whether to take 10 or plus 10 or minus 10. If you take sign wrong, means total answer will become wrong. Okay, we should measure from this pole in this direction because object is here. We should measure like that, means we are measuring in opposite to incident ray. So u should be taken as negative. So minus 10. Clear? And one more you think, you should be careful that this is in centimeter, this is also centimeter. So no problem, we can directly get the value. Is equal to n2 is 1.5 minus n1 is 1 upon radius of curvature for this curved surface. Radius this side will be there, radius will be this side. Yes or no? Yes, this will be the radius of curvature. Clear? That means we should measure in the direction of incident ray is like this. In the direction of incident ray we should measure, means we should take it as positive only. So how much it is given? 5 centimeter. Let us write 5. So your answer V will come in terms of centimeters only, because this and this you kept it in centimeters. What is the answer? Clear? Okay. Now calculate 1.5 upon V minus half minus plus by 10 is equal to 1.5 minus 1 is 0.5. 0.5 by 5. Correct? Yes. So 1.5 by V plus 1 by 10 is equal to 0.5 by 5 is equal to how much? 5 by 50. 1 by 10. Correct? 0.5 by 5 is equal to 5 upon 50 is equal to 1 by 10. Are you getting? Okay? Yes. Now what will happen, sir? This 1 by 10 will go that side. You will get 1.5 by V. 1.5 by V is equal to that. What is it now? 1 by 10 minus 1 by 10. This total is 0. So 1.5 by V is equal to 0. So V is equal to how much now? Where you will get? V is equal to 0 or 1.5 by 0. That means you will get the image at infinity. What, sir? Yes. See, this is object distance, this is the radius of curvature, I have taken 5. If you take the radius of curvature, let us take 10 only. Now what you will get the answer, let us check. Okay, radius of curvature is 10. Now see, what you will get the answer. So it is 10. What do you get? 1.5 by V plus 1 by 10 is equal to 5 by 100. Correct? Yes. 1.5 by V is equal to 5 by 100 minus 1 by 10. So 1.5 by V is equal to, what is LCM? 100. Correct? This is 50 minus 1. Correct? LCM is 100 or you know? 1000
15 minutes 100. Yes. So you get 1.5 by V is equal to minus 50 by 1000.
Have multiplied LCM. Why to take LCM? 100 into 10 is 1000. Back multiply. 5 into 10 is 15 minus 10 into 100 into 1 is 100. 50 minus 100 is minus 50. So 0 cancel.
Clear. So 1.5 by V is equal to minus 5 by 100 you are getting. Clear. Then what is V, sir? V is equal to, you will get 1.5 into 100 by 5 with negative sign. Here minus 1.5 is nothing but 3 by 2 into 100 by 5. 5 1s are 5 4s, 5 2s are 10, 0. 2 1s are 2 10s are, means minus 30 centimeters.
Minus K. Minus K means where image will form. Image will form this side only. Image will form this side only. Minus indicates that image will be same side of the object. Because we should measure some pole, no? If you measure like this, then only you get minus.
Okay, Anna? Clear? So like this, you will get the so many questions. This type of questions, you will get so many. This type of questions. I hope you are understanding what I am saying. So what is the formula we should use? N2 by V minus N1 by U is equal to N2 minus N1 by R we should use. Okay. I'll take one more example. Let us imagine there is a glass ball. Okay. Spherical surface glass. Okay. Now this is having, let us imagine this is having a radius. 5 centimeter radius it is. Here and its refractive index is 1.5. Okay, this is the center nana what I am saying. Okay, now somewhere else here object is present. Here object is present somewhere else here. And this distance from this surface is, let us imagine it is a 2 centimeter distance it takes. Okay, and we are seeing from this surface, from this side. We are seeing from this side. Okay, na? We are observer is listed. Okay, if the observer sees this object, where image will form to this? Actually, where it will form, where it will appear to be. Okay, so what to do? Ray, you should draw. And from that ray, this will be the normal, na? This will be the normal. So this is the denser medium, this is the rarer medium. This m is equal to 1 unit. So when a ray enters into rarer medium, it will bend away from the normal. Actually it has to go like this, but it will bend away from the normal like this. Okay, now let us imagine these are very close, so that this refractive ray also will reach the observer. Okay, now where image form? So you have to take U how much, V you need to find, N1 how much, N2 how much, R how much you need to find. Okay, yes. Now what is U, sir? So incident ray is going like this. From this surface we should measure like this. Means object distance should be negative. How much it is? Minus 2 centimeter. Okay. What is N1? N1 is the refractive index of the medium from which ray is coming. How much it is? 1.5. Yes, 1.5. What is N2? N2 is the refractive index of medium into which ray is going. How much? 1 I have given. 1. Radius of curvature is 5. Plus or minus, what we should take? See, we should measure radius of curvature for this curved surface will be this side only. Means we should measure opposite direction to incident ray. Means minus 5 we should take. Now apply the formula. N2 by V minus N1 by U is equal to N2 minus N1 by R. N2 value how much is 1 upon V minus N1 1.5. upon U minus 2 is equal to N2 1 minus N1 1.5 upon radius minus 5. You will get the answer 1 by V plus, this is 3 by 2 minus of minus plus, 3 by 2 is 3 by 4. Correct? What I am writing? 1.5 is 3 by 2, 3 by 2 by 2 is 3 by 4 is equal to 1 minus 1.5 is 0.5. माइनस माइनस कैंसल 0.5 बाई 5 यस 1 बाई वी प्लस 3 बाई 4 इज इक्वल टू व्हाट इज 0.5 बाई 5 हाउ मच 0.5 बाई 5 इज इक्वल टू 5 बाई 50 मींस 1 बाई 10 करेक्ट 1 बाई 10 सो 1 बाई वी इज इक्वल टू 1 बाई 10 माइनस 3 बाई 4 So what you will get for this? What you will get the answer, Nana? Calculate. One by V will become LCM is cross multiply them 10 into 4 40. 4 minus 4 1 4 minus 30. So 1 by V is equal to -26/40. 4 minus 30 is -26, -26/40. So V is equal to -40/26. We'll calculate, you'll get the answer. How much it is? How much you will get? That will be the answer. I hope now you are understanding how to apply these values. Okay? So what is that one? 40/26 is 1.53. -1.53. Minus sign indicates that image will be center here only. Means from this curved surface. This 1.53 from where I am saying? 1.53 I am saying from this curved surface. Na? From the pole. Means here image may form here. See, exactly ray diagram of the same. Same only. Clear? How to apply? I hope you understand now. If the question is, if the observer observes from this side, then R is same, N1 same, N2 same, everything same. But object distance is different. This will be the object distance from here to here. This is object distance. This is 5, this is 2 means this is 3. Means total 8 centimeter it is. Object distance will change. I hope you are understanding what I am saying. Clear? If the observer is not this side, if the observer is this side, question then ask like this also. Then this is the object distance for this surface. Whereas for this surface, object distance is this much from here to here. How much it is? This is 2 means this is 3. 3 plus 5, 8, 8 centimeters. Minus 8 we should take here. Then your total answer will change. And this calculation you must be speed up. You should do very fast. Okay?